congratulations to you both, you know, on Mr. Turner and having it in the festival. And I'd like to ask you both, you know, what it feels like to have a movie in such a huge festival and, you know, it's just so respected around the world.
Mm. It's wonderful. It's so exciting. It's just great to walk down the street and people who've seen it are coming up saying, wow, that was really great, well done. That's a lovely feeling, yeah, certainly.
I was quite naive. I didn't realise that it was such a huge festival, and it seems it's grown quite a lot over the last few years, and it's just fantastic to be here. Yeah, I just wish I could see more films.
Absolutely. And congratulations to both of you on the film. And it's such an interesting story, and all of the characters are so complex and interesting at the same time. So maybe we'll start with you, Marion, first. And you know, what was it that appealed to you about, you know, your character and, you know, being on a Mike Leigh project?
Well, I love always being on a Mike Leigh project. We first worked together actually in 1981, so there we go. We've had gaps, but he asked me a few months before we started preparation for this, and he said, "Well, not a lot is known about Mrs. Booth, who I play." Who was Turner's mistress, I guess, I say mistress, he was never married, so in effect his wife, for the last kind of 18, 20 years of his life. But not a lot is known about her, so what was great was that I could, with Mike, you know, just invent this woman along the lines we wanted her to, you know, to be. There were certain definites that were known about her. She was his landlady in Margate, which is a little seaside town on the southeast coast of England, which in those days in Georgian Victorian times was a thriving holiday resort where people would go and take the waters, and it was a very glamorous place to be in those days. She was an interesting woman, illiterate.
She was.
But she'd made money, she was twice widowed. Mm. And so the rest, we used our imagination to flesh her out, which was great. I wanted her to be warm.
Absolutely. And how about your character? I mean, what a transformation that you went through.
Yes, yes.
And how uncomfortable that looked with, you know, the skin condition that she had and amongst everything else that was going on for her. And she was quite quiet. And so what was your take on her when you first came on this project?
Well, again, there was not much known about her, but the few key things we did know was such a brilliant nucleus for a character, and I was just hooked instantly because she's one of those marginal characters that you don't normally see represented on film, and that's why I love working with Mike, because he puts them right there. And she just reminded me of all the spooky women from when I was a kid, and you know, like weird Eleanor Rigby type characters where you're just like, what's her background, how did she get there? And I just loved the idea of exploring that, and I loved it. And you know, leaving vanity at the door and just going for it, and the discomfort of the makeup and everything kind of added to the richness, I hope, because it was a pretty uncomfortable life she had.
It absolutely did.
Yeah, but you know, actually being a housekeeper for that kind of person in that area was actually a very good job. So
I found it really interesting about Turner and with the women that he had in his lives, that, you know, he got something different from them. Mm. But he didn't really give them much, it seemed. Mm. But how do you think, you know, your character sort of related to him?
I think he did give them something in his way.
Right.
I think they both, well, certainly for Mrs. Booth, she understood his limitations. But I think she also recognized a complex, sensitive, caring human being, and he was all of those things, as well as being socially gruff and abrupt and rude and drunk sometimes as he got older. She recognized early on that he was very special, and although she was illiterate and knew nothing about the history of art, and of course when she first met him she had no idea that he was this great painter. How would she have known? But I suppose, you know, there was a class thing. He was working class. And I think with the world he had to work in, the Royal Academy, his patrons, Lord Egremont, he was mixing with the English aristocracy, it was probably quite relaxing to go home and be with a woman or women that were from his world that he grew up with. So, you know, people sort of say, well, what did Mrs. Booth get out of it? She just loved him.
Yeah.
And I think she always liked being busy. And of course she could be busy. She had him to look after. She kept him, he got a little bit smarter, a little bit cleaner when he was with her. She liked washing his clothes, and I think she was a practical woman that just liked looking after people.
And as his playing his housekeeper, how do you think his relation, like how do you, it just seemed like there wasn't enough backstory with that. You kind of wanted to know a little bit more. You got a little taste of it.
Yeah, it's pretty enigmatic. I think that was their thing. She asked no questions. She was satisfied with whatever she got, and the richness when he gave her attention was enough to carry her through. And she'd had such a hideous life up to the point of being with him. Well, not hideous actually. She was educated, but she was a nobody. She was orphaned and part of another family. And you know, this he gave her however little attention, it was obviously very rich and carried her through. And she asked no questions, and she could keep a secret, and you know, she was obviously very dependable and did what was required. And he left her a lot of money and the charge of the house until she died, so he in later years he, you know, showed his value.
And there was a warmth in the family, I think, when I watched the film, when the father was alive and see Hannah, it was a warm
threesome.
Little unit, you know, as was Mrs. Booth and Turner, there was a warmth, and I guess in what was then a very hard, harsh world, you needed people to look out for you and to stick with. So I guess
let's talk about working on a Mike Lee film. I mean, I say he's a reluctant icon, but he the way that he works is very unique, and a lot of improv. And you've worked with him before. You know, how does he help you on set, or were you nervous at all to go into this and sort of, you know,
no,
take charge?
He doesn't take kindly to nerves. I don't
know.
When I first worked with him years ago in Topsy Turvy, I was pretty nervous, and he was fantastic at saying, you know, leave that at the door, you're here because I want you, and let's get on with it. So you've got that safety, and I don't know, just the exchange of ideas and creativity, there's nothing
it's
else
wonderful.
Like it.
It's a gas. It's hard. It is hard work. And
you have
to
come prepared.
Of you, so you have to come prepared.
Oh, definitely.
You can't really cheat. You have to go with it. And he's pretty sharp. You know, he can tell if you are cheating or making something up. He spots it. I realised a long time ago. So it's not even worth pretending you've been up all night doing the research when you haven't. But it's great. I really love it. And of course, the great thing is when you come on set for the first time. From my point of view, you're less nervous than you usually are, because
definitely.
You know what he wants from you and what's required from the character's point of view. And so you can dispense with the usual thing actors feel when you start off working on a film or a television job or a theatre job, thinking, is this what they want? Is this why they cast me? What? With Mike, you've done the proper preparation and you know.
Yeah,
so that gives you a freedom and you can be relaxed and enjoy it.
It is, yeah. I never feel so at ease filming than with Mike, actually.
Mm. Well, however he works and your performances, it's came out like a genius piece of art in itself. You know, same with Timothy. What was it like working with him? I mean, he lost himself into the character immensely. What was that dynamic like for each of you?
Well, I don't know, because of the way Mike works, you're all evolving your characters, and so you're not really objectively looking at the other actor as another actor. You're saying, all right, this is the character that my character is now responding to. And it's all kind of bubbling along, and it feels exciting. And Tim's always great to work with. I've worked with him a couple of times over the years. But all of the actors on this were fantastic. I mean, there were 70-plus actors. Of course, I didn't get to work with all of them, but... you know, as far as I'm concerned, there's not a duff performance in there. Yeah. Everybody's doing really interesting work.
Yeah. And it was a long haul for him, because the film's about
so it's like every scene.
He was in day in, day out, and speaking that language, which is not easy. And, you know, sometimes there's late changes. And so it's evolving all the time. But, yeah, it took a lot of energy. But and then he's daft as a brush when we're finished.
And great film.
It was a great film, and you guys did an absolutely fantastic job. Congratulations.